We didn't know what record was coming next. For all those years, we never knew what the next record was going to be. The Loft really, really took hold as an event, or as a place to go.
That was very nicely put.
In about 1972. It was 72, because David invited me in late 1970. And I, in turn, took Michael Capello and Francis and a bunch
and
of other
DJs.
I had such
a social life at the time. I had so much free time.
So Francis would come whenever he could, because it was only on a Saturday night, and we all worked on Saturday nights.
So I would come after work.
And the Loft was only open until 7 a.m. So we would leave work at 3, 3.30 by the time we packed up our records.
Saturday nights was 3 o'clock.
Yeah, Saturday nights before the law in New York. Yeah. I don't know what the law
quarter
is now.
Quarter 3, I don't know.
Quarter 3, we start playing the last record.
You play your last record. It was last call at 2.30 for drinks.
So 3 o'clock on Saturday, 4 o'clock during the week, every other night. So by we'd get to the Loft at maybe 4 o'clock, so we'd have like 3 hours of the Loft, but we'd catch like the last bit of the peak. But this is again now, 1972. Although the Loft had been happening before that for a while, but it was very, very underground, and it was black, and it was gay, and it was just the most wonderful place I'd ever been, really, as far as...
Well, it was someplace where you could blend in, and you were different.
Yeah.
The Loft.
And you could be like, you could be like comfortable.
Yeah, the Loft was the most comfortable place you've ever been.
It was like the sanctuary where you were, like, it was like, the place became occasionally with the lighting, a show place. You know, you could kind of blend in the Loft.
Who's Francis Grosser?
That's a good question.
And what did Francis Grosser do that's so significant today?
That's a heck of a question. When Francis, I guess, elevated the art or started making an art, something that became artful. I guess that's what Francis Grosser did.
Did Francis Grosser discover mixing?
I don't know. He was probably the first DJ, but I don't know if he discovered mixing. It just turned out. I guess like you discover fire. You know, one day something got hot and, you know, they were eating it raw. And they decided, hey, let's get the taste better hot and, you know, cooked. I don't know. It was like that. It was like a whirlwind.
The fact that there were two turntables and somebody was mixing records together, not just playing one record after another, but creatively mixing, and we didn't call it mixing, and this has to be pointed out. We called them changes. Did you hear that change?
Did you hear the change I made with those two records?
I actually said
those words, changes.
Yeah.
That's what it was. First of all, you have to know the music.
You really have to know the music.
Really?
You had to know every bar, every note of it.
On a regular LP at the time, you had the lighter sides would be where there was vocal quality, and the darker part would be sound. And you had to know that too. If you just want to play bit.
We were reading the grooves. Without headphones, we used to read the grooves. That's exactly what we did. We read the grooves. How else would you? That's what we did. We read the grooves.
I mean, you really had to know the music and know how it started. And like I said, the average 45 at the time was about 2 minutes and 13 seconds.
The average night was about 12 hours. At the sanctuary, the people were like the show almost, because it was crazy. People were nuts. Everybody was just wild, absolutely wild. But at the Loft, the place, the Loft, the music, and the sound was the party. That was the event. So it was a whole different. It was all transitions when the party became.
The party.
The party, exactly. With us, it was a night in a nightclub in a bar with liquor, and you had to deal with all kinds of different things. At the Loft, there was no liquor, so basically you had people who were just expressing themselves in a whole different way. The tightness and the oneness with the music was just amazing.
Mancuso was arrested.
Yeah, David was arrested. Absolutely. I was there that night. What happened was at the Haven and the Sanctuary, we used to have a light system where green was there, the cops are nearby, red was there at the door, white there in.
David was taking a tremendous risk in even having that kind of club.
Yeah. It wasn't a club, it was a party.
The police department for one.
Yeah, I mean he was having a gathering for people.
I have a lot of close friends.
It was time to just be up front, be who you are, and enjoy nightlife, because it was the only nightlife we had. Them girls dedicated.